guys, welcome back to the channel and welcome to the beautiful state of Vermont. I have a tiny timber frame house right here behind me. Definitely one of the most unique places I've stayed at so far, and it's on a gorgeous plot of land in southern Vermont. So before we hop into the tour, if you want to check out this Airbnb, the link to the Airbnb listing is down below in the description. Also, if you want to save money in Airbnb, my Airbnb affiliate link as well is down there. You save money, I save money off our next bookings. It's a win-win for the both of us, so go ahead and check that out. But I'm gonna hop into the tour right now. I'm really excited to show you guys this tiny timber frame cabin. This tiny timber frame house is located about 1 mile down this beautiful road that goes through this forest. And we're in Putney, Vermont today. It's in the southern part of the state. We're going to turn into the property and you begin to see the tiny timber frame house up here in the distance. You're going to park your car here on the left-hand side, and this sign details that Honeycrisp Cottage, which is the name of the Airbnb, is on the left, and Mountain Escape, which is the owner's house, is on the right. We're now gonna inch a little bit closer now though to the tiny timber frame house and check out the exterior. Welcome to Honeycrisp Cottage. This definitely feels like a custom tiny house build in my opinion. I've never seen any exterior on a tiny house quite like this. It's definitely very unique. I absolutely loved all the windows right here. There's 8 windows looking out into the woods and just perfectly fitted into its surroundings. As we veer out right here, you can see just absolutely beautiful area, very secluded, kind of its own little section on the property. And now it looks out, actually there's a fire pit area with a grill and some chairs. And it actually really looks out into the forest. There's some trails for some hiking you can do back in that area, and there's 4 chairs right here as well. So it's definitely a really amazing hangout spot for family, friends, or a small group. I actually, you know, geared up the fire pit at night. I took some night shots right here. There's just some string lights that go above as well. It's a really nice setup out there. But now we've seen all the exterior has to offer, let's head inside. Welcome to the interior of your tiny house. This is the site you will see as soon as you enter, and upon my first impression, definitely what I thought initially was, wow, this is so much space inside here. It's a very open floor plan. Actually, the only place that's kind of walled off is the bathroom for obvious reasons. Even though it's only 280 square feet, it feels like a heck of a lot more space than that because of the open floor plan. I'm going to start over here in the kitchen area. And a lot of tiny houses I've reviewed in the past kind of skimp out on the kitchen area, basically just due to lack of space, which I completely understand. But this tiny house did an amazing job though. They're basically fully stocked. It felt like a full kitchen to me. You have your typical knife setup over there in the right hand corner. There's a bunch of remotes right here. There is like 4 remotes controlling everything from the air conditioning to entertainment to speakers. So definitely kind of a lot of fun things to explore as soon as you get to your tiny house. Then behind that, there's a whole tea setup. I end up being more of a tea guy than a coffee guy, so it's nice to kind of cater to both types of people. There's a coffee press. There's some local coffee here as well. It's definitely a nice touch to kind of bring a local business into this. And there's the toaster. And actually the same exact toaster I have back in my own home. So again, definitely didn't skip out on the appliances. There's some utensils and kind of your typical tea kettle. So again, great for your morning tea or coffee over here in this area. I was very impressed again with all the appliances and just how much value they packed into this space here in the kitchen. Even the range has so much space to cook a full meal, then have your sink right here. And I just kind of went through a few of the drawers for you guys. And again, it was pretty fully stocked with everything from the utensils to garbage and recycling to plenty of plates. The next thing I want to cover, I noticed on this plaque, this is actually a very energy efficient tiny house. They're certified by Efficiency Vermont. And also when I checked out their Airbnb listing as well, they're also LEED compliant, or LEED compliant, which stands for Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design. I've heard this organization before. They typically only certify very large industrious buildings such as skyscrapers in New York City. I had no idea they certified smaller buildings, especially a tiny house in Vermont. When I spoke to the owner, she confirmed further it's LEED certified, no trees were harmed, and they have a freaking backup Tesla battery. Now that we've covered the energy efficient portion of this tiny house, I'm going to continue in the main living room space. So again, very, very wide open space right here. And also this couch was incredibly comfy. I was really tired. I left the city that day and driven all the way up to Vermont. So I dozed off for a little nap. But now just covering the rest of this space as well, looking out more towards the entrance. Actually below the coffee table is some games. So again, pretty nice to hang out with the group or some friends. And I checked out a bunch of the books and some of the other things the host left behind. They had a very in-depth and detailed welcome guide. Everything from local restaurants to hiking trails to maps in the area. I thought that was pretty cool. And kind of moving on here as well, there's some cool, you know, travel books here by like the bucket list, and also as well as the guest book, which I definitely encourage you guys to check out if you do stay here. Again, just recommendations, just kind of feedback from other people who have stayed at this Airbnb. Definitely a nice touch. The next area I'll cover is what I dubbed the goodie shelf, for lack of a better term, in this corner. It's all locally sourced ingredients and goodies from local businesses in the Vermont area. So everything from stickers right here, then this is a local coffee company I saw called Duchess. So they have some coffee, you know, goods for you guys to check out. And also down below there, we are in Vermont, so of course you need maple syrup goods in every shape and form possible. I didn't even know if these ones were here on the right hand side. And then some really cool candy and more goodies, you know, on the bottom shelf. They actually have an iPad down here. You can check out Lily right there. You don't have to, you know, bug the host or ask how to purchase it. Really, really simple. Also a very nice additional income stream for the host. I thought they were great business people. I was impressed. Now we're going to cover the sleeping situation here in this tiny timber frame house. So there are two beds or two sleeping areas. The first right here is where I slept. This is right beneath the loft. You can see that ladder right there. Again, plenty of space for a couple or for two people to fit into this area. I had it all to myself though. Again, I was very, very tired on that day, so I was testing out the bed and I don't really know what I'm doing here. I'm like trying to dance or like show you guys how big the bed is, but I was really tired, so I just kind of passed out. The last space I'll cover on the ground floor is the bathroom. So again, it has privacy, it has this sliding door. We're not going to enter inside and check it out. And again, I thought it was very spacious, you know, again, considering the overall 280 square feet. You have your shower stall, and you have a little shelf there to kind of put all your bathroom supplies. You have your typical toilet and your counter and a towel rack. And then actually over here on the right-hand side, you have a full-length mirror. So again, made great use of this space. I think the host knocked it out of the park. Real quick, if you're enjoying this video, please give it a like, give it a thumbs up, send this to a friend, and also consider subscribing. I come with weekly videos just like this, showcasing the most unique Airbnbs, hotels, and rental properties, so be sure to subscribe. I wanted to point out a few more small things from a design aspect in the main area. So the first being is these massive windows you're gonna see. They're absolutely gorgeous and you can't miss them as soon as you walk in. There's three on the bottom that are definitely a little bit larger, and up top there are three more. So it lets in some amazing natural light. You can see right here from this shot, and it's very easy to open up one of these windows and you kind of then look out into the beautiful forest area near the fire pit. Another area I'll cover as well is actually the ceiling. I don't typically showcase ceilings on this channel. Those are not, you know, very interesting. This thing was absolutely stunning. Because again, this is a timber frame house. Has all these beautiful timber beams. You look up top, I think it's very well done. They even have air conditioning here as well. It's very rare for Airbnbs in Vermont because it's so cold so much of the year. When I was there, it was much, much hotter out. So it was very nice to have AC, but absolutely loved just kind of looking up towards the windows, seeing the beautiful ceiling and seeing this area. But now it's time to head up top to the loft. I'm going to head up top to the loft via this ladder. It is pretty steep, so just note that, but I had no issues getting up there. And welcome to the loft. There are two lights above the bed. There's two windows as well to let in some nice light, but I found it to be very spacious. I've definitely stayed in some lofts and slept there overnight myself, and they felt like very cramped to me, like I was gonna bang my head as soon as I woke up. Definitely did not get that vibe up here in this loft. I thought it to be very spacious, actually. You can see right here, you kind of wake up every morning to those nice, you know, gorgeous wooden beams in the ceiling, kind of right there. It's very nice, and this is now the view looking down from the loft into the main area. And again, just felt so spacious to me. Everything from the kitchen area to the living room to the goodie shelf, just this entire space, entire tiny house, like way more than 280 square feet. I hope you guys enjoyed the tour of this tiny timber frame house in southern Vermont. I really enjoyed showing it off to you guys. If you liked the video, please consider giving it a thumbs up. Give it a like. It really helps me get the video out to more people. Also consider subscribing. I'd really appreciate it. I sincerely enjoy making these videos for you guys. So if more people subscribe, this gives me the motivation to keep making these videos and pumping them out for you guys. So please consider liking and subscribing. Also leave a comment down below if your feature of this tiny timber frame house was. For me personally, it was the string lights out back and the fire pit. Just that whole setup I thought was just perfect for the location, for the surrounding area. So let me know down in the comments, and until then, I will see you in next week's video.